sat down and thought about what, which parts of the body are the weaker ones? What does a weaker part of the body look like? I mean, I can tell you the weaker parts of my body are the ones that are injured and hurt. Maybe that's what he's talking about. Maybe he's talking about those people who are injured and hurt. They're the weaker parts of our body. And they are indispensable. How are the injured people of our church indispensable? And the parts of the body that think that are less honourable are treated with special honour. Which ones are the ones without honour? Which one of you hasn't got honour? And we'll give you great honour. Which part of the bodies are unpresentable? I know which parts of my body are unpresentable. I cover them, that's why. But which one of you are the unpresentable ones? We should cover you up. Honestly, do we read these scriptures and wonder what it looks like today in our church? Do we fulfill what Paul says? Do we treat the ones that are less honourable with more honour? Well, the first thing is, if we don't know who they are, we're not going to find them. The other thing, have you ever noticed you have two hands? Do you know, I know this sounds like a weird statement, but of course I have two hands. I have 2 feet. I have 2 ears, 2 eyes. Why? Because we know that if I only had one hand, it would seem pretty impossible to work. Now, I've got a theory. It's just a mind back. My hand was never meant to work alone. It was meant to work with the other hand. I have 2 feet because I was meant to move with 2 feet, not with one. I'm supposed to listen with 2 ears. I'm supposed to work with 2 eyes, not one. Now you may say, well, what's your point? How many of us do work in the church by ourselves? And we don't ask anyone to help us because we don't want to burden them. We don't think it's exciting. We don't want to be rejected. But do you know what? We were never meant to do anything on our own. We were meant to do it with someone else. And I've got to say, I'm one of the worst offenders for this problem. I do so many things in the church by myself because I don't want to burden you. Because you've got so many other burdens. And that's such a bad example to set the church. We need to find another hand and work with that other hand. Not just because we need help, but because we're not meant to be doing it alone. We need to be seeing that we're not doing them a disservice by asking them to help us. We are honouring them by telling them that we need their help. That's the other thing I find too. I don't need help. I can do it on my own. That denies our part as being part of a body that needs help. I want you to think about that. I need to think about that. I need to work at that part of my personality and my part of being in the church to understand it is not a failure to ask someone for help. And I don't and shouldn't do it on my own. Paul talks again about all the different gifts. Now, you've heard them. I wonder what you think about the top list. The first one is apostles. Well, we would say we don't have any apostles now. This letter suggests that apostles are not a historical position that was only available when Jesus was alive. This tells us that there are apostles that can be, there are people who can be apostles today who can be close to Jesus and share that experience of knowing Jesus on a one-to-one. I don't know about you, I struggled for years believing I didn't know Jesus, looking for people who had. I guess I was looking for an apostle. The second one is a prophet, someone who speaks more closely to God and listens and He's got the scroll that has the prophets. And he doesn't just read. I would have assumed that they had it opened up where he was to read. So here you go, here's your scroll, now read it. And he goes, yeah, no, I don't want to read that today. I'm going to turn to the part that I want to read. And he's rolling and scrolling, and he finally gets to the part that he wants to read, and he reads from Isaiah. And I don't know what they were thinking, but for him, he just wants them to know that this scripture is fulfilled. Jesus had everything. He had all the gifts. He didn't need anybody else's help. He didn't need others to heal with him. He didn't need others to proclaim with him. He didn't need anybody's help. And yet, even though he did everything on his own, a full body, he still connected with 12 people because he knew he couldn't do it on his own. He had to do it in community. Here we see also the idea that Jesus has let go of all those gifts and then decided that he can't do them anymore. He's not here. So we have to do them. Paul says, strive for the greater gifts. Well, the first question I have asked is, which gift have you got? As I said, being here is a part of the body. It plays its part in community. But we then move on to things, and I'm starting at the lower, speaking in tongues, guidance. Are you a guide? Do you inspire and help people? Are you a helper? Are you a healer? Are you a person who can do miracles? Are you the teacher, the prophet, the apostle? They're not designated at our birth. I got to the door, God gave me the apostle card, I'm going to go be the apostle. One thing I believe about the church is that when we sit there and say, God didn't choose me to have that gift, it is not because God doesn't want to give it to you, it's because you don't want to use it. Each one of us could be up here preaching. Why are you not preaching? Each of you could be out there healing people. Why are you not healing? Why do we not want the gifts? We can sit and wait and say, when he gives it to me, I'll use it. I have found that we start by using the gifts we have and desiring the more important gifts, by living that relationship. I have seen so many people start their lives in the church at the lowest level and then go on to become priests, not because they were chosen by God, but because in their journey of serving God with their heart, seeking out God with their heart, they were move to go more and more deeply into how they live their faith. Until we and every Christian decides that getting closer to God is our purpose on life, and that as we do that, God will give us the gifts we need to serve the people, our church will not grow. We can wait. And that's all we'll ever do. Some of you may say, but I'm past it. We are not talking about a label given by the church. We are not talking about getting a vestment, not getting about being commissioned or ordained. To proclaim God's